the MicroLead program. I guess this is a perfect segue into that, isn't it?
Absolutely. MicroLead is a brand new partnership with a wonderful organization known as the UN Capital Development Fund. It is a project which is very much focused on helping UNCDF, as it's known, to establish a number of new microfinance institutions or microbanks across Africa. And the number one service which we are emphasizing is savings, because that's the number one service which poor people want.
They want to save.
They want to
save. But I didn't think that they had any money to save.
You would be so surprised. We are looking into, and much more is coming to light through a number of studies which show that poor people do more than 26 complicated transactions just to save $1. And to manage and stretch a dollar. What is heartening is the fact that they do save money in different ways. They save money in very insecure ways,
yes,
in
such
goats
as?
And cattle. They save actual cash under their mattress or in shoes. These are all insecure places, as we know. In an emergency, you might have your cow, and what you really need is to, you can't sell a cow, which is your one asset, which is actually producing milk for the family.
Mm-hmm.
So when you can't just sell off a leg or you can't sell off a thigh, you need to sell the whole cow. If they had access to saving services, which could help them sort of insulate themselves to some degree from economic shocks, that would be a huge service. And more often than not, and it's reported many, many times, the number one service compared to loans, people want savings. It's 12 times the demand for credit than for credit.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm hearing actually very practical words, mm-hmm. savings, and it could be underneath your mattress, or it could be in a cow or a goat. I'm not hearing words like financial, for example. I mean, when I think financial here in the United States, I think Wall Street, I think going to my bank.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking a very practical standpoint. Is this something new for this part of the world?
It is not something new for this part of the world, but it is something which needs to grow. If you look in parts of West Africa, in fact parts of East Africa, there has been a long savings culture, except savings are being kept in very informal channels, mm-hmm. under the mattress, etc. What we want to be able to encourage and create is opportunities for people to save in much more secure places, and that is going to be in regulated institutions. And it's institutions, whether they're banks, microfinance institutions, cooperatives, which are going to be much closer to where people actually live. And in some cases, that may mean working through new delivery channels like mobile phones, through technology,
mm-hmm.
but most importantly is creating opportunities where people can save small amounts of money at very little cost and nearby.